let's see what is the Java I/O. So I/O means it's your input and output streams, the operations related to the input and output streams. So Java uses the concept of streams to make the I/O operations. So just to take a data into the program and pass the data from your program to the outside entity. That is, first is input and next is your output. That is nothing but your input streams and output streams. And data is always flowing in the form of streams. What is a streams? It's a sequence of characters. So in Java, if you want to deal with the I/O operations, so Java gives you the java.io package to do this. So in a java.io package, the related classes are available. So java.io package contains all the classes required for input and output operations. And we have to just import first this package and then start the coding related to the I/O. We can perform the file handling in Java by using the I/O API, because in a file handling we are reading a data from the file, or we are writing a data into the file. This is nothing but the data streams are coming into the program or going outside the program. Okay, so in case of reading the file, your Java applications are opening that file and read the data, and that data is coming towards your program. That means it's input stream. And when you write a data, so from your application you are writing data into the file, that is your output stream. Okay, so for that also, this is also I/O operations, and that also we are using the I/O API, which is in java.io package. Now Java for file handling, the two approaches are available. It's one is a character oriented approach and one is a byte oriented approach. So first we see character oriented approach and then we switch to the byte oriented approach. So what is a character oriented approach and what are the classes are responsible for the character oriented approach? So Java file writer and file reader, these are classes are available, file writer and file reader, and these classes are used to write and read a data from the text files. This is important. So it is a text files. These are the character oriented classes. That means character oriented approach is used in these classes, and using these classes you can read a data and write a data which is human readable form. Okay, this is not a byte or. So Java has suggested not to use the file input stream and file output stream classes if you have to read and write textual information. So this approach is only for the character oriented, not for byte oriented. For a byte oriented, you can go with the file input stream and output stream. That is our next approach. For a file writer class, so Java file writer class is used to write a character oriented data into the file, and the constructors are available for file writer is file writer string argument, and this is the name of the file. So it creates a new file and it gets a file name in a string. You have another constructor for file writer, that is the file class and the instance of file. And for a file class you have the name of the file. So two constructors are available for file writer. We can create an object of file writer either using this constructor or this constructor. So basically what is use of parameterized constructor is like this. So ready-made constructors are available, and which takes a string argument and which takes a file instance. So which is suitable for our application, we have to just use it. So it's a function name, that is a constructor names are definitely same, but the arguments are different. It's a polymorphism, right? Multiple forms are available. And why it is available? Because user, it gives you more facility to the user, which user want to use, user can use it. So two options are available if you want to create a file writer object. Okay, and file writer class will help you to write a data into the file. So I will show you the demo also. So file writer class having some methods, and look how many write methods are available. Write. So 1, 2, 3, and the public void write. Look, it access specifier is same, return type is same, but the string that is arguments are different. Here is a string argument used, here character argument is used, here character array is used. Now when the function name, method name is same, but the arguments are, the method signature is different, in that case it is a function overloading. It's nothing but a polymorphism, one of the powerful feature of polymorphism. It's a function method overloading, function overloading. And if you want to write a data using FileWriter class into the file, and suppose you have a string data, then you can go with this method. If you have only character data, you can go with this method. If you have a character array, you can go with this method. So it depends on the user, how user want to write. If you want to write in character, you go with the second one. If you want to write with the character array, you can go with the third one. And if you have a straightforward string, you can go with the first one. Okay. And next is your flush. Flushes the data writer. That means whatever the data is available inside the object, after writing, you have to just clear, flush it. So just clear the buffer and then close your object. So what is the purpose to close? Because here you are writing the data into the file, and that file instance is in running state. After writing, your operation is complete. You have to close it, otherwise other process will not access your file, because your instance is in a running state and other cannot access unless and until you close this. Okay, so that's why we have to close it. And this close operation we have to write in a finally block. So that also I will show you. Okay, so at the time of exception handling, I told you that what is use of finally block. If you have not gone through this, you can refer that video. Okay, and this is the simple straightforward program. So it's a public static void main. The instance is created, file writer fw is equal to new file writer, the name of the file and f dot write, and this is a string available. So you have to, I am using the first method of write. Here the string data is available, and I'm closing the instance. And here try catch is provided. Why try catch is provided? Because file writer is this is the, when you create an instance, this instance is depends on this file. If the file is not available or file is corrupted, so Java is depends on the external resources, and it is a check type of exception. So in a check type of exception, it is compulsory to provide try catch block. That means you have to handle the exception, otherwise compiler will give you error. So I will show you this within a program. So I switch to my screen, that is demo for a demo. So I will give a name for the test file writer. I want the main method. It depends on the application. Now I want to write a data into the file. That's why as per the theory, so we have to go with the file writer class. And file writer, so now here you have to just remember, try to remember the naming conventions in Java. So suppose the file writer is the name of the class, so how to write that, how to write this? F is capital and W is capital. So automatically your this instance, this syntax will help you to create the instance. And file writer class is available in IO package, that's why it is showing me error. So first I try to create an object is equal to new file writer. Okay. And now just try to read the error. So look at first error is import file writer java.io, because this file writer class is available in different package and we have to access into our current package. So I just try to use the import statement. Now look at the first import statement gets added, and now I have another error, second error. Now this is the error, and just now read the error. Constructor file writer is undefined because I am using parameterless constructor here and it is not available in file writer class. Okay, so I will show you the Java documentation, how to see the file writer class and what are the constructors are available. So just go to your Java documentation for the Java 8. Okay, and just click to Java SE API. And here you have a list of packages. You just go to the java.io, click on java.io, java.io package having these many interfaces. Okay, and here you have a list of classes, right? So many classes are available. So maybe approximately 20 to 30 classes are available. Okay, and these many exception classes are available for the IO package, and these one is the IO error class is available for the errors. Okay, so all exceptions, these exceptions are inbuiltly available. That means these exceptions will help you to handle the IO related exceptions. So these classes will help you. These are the objects, and here you have a file writer. So alphabetically in a list of classes you search it, file writer class. So it is a file writer class. Just click on this file writer. So file class file writer is open. It is in java.io. Look the hierarchy. Topmost is object class, then writer class. Object class is in language package, writer class in IO package. Output stream writer is in IO package, and file writer is the subclass of your output stream writer. This is also in IO. So these three classes are in IO, but topmost is in your language package. File writer is the subclass of output stream. Output stream writer is the subclass of writer, and writer is the subclass of your object. So 0th level, 1 level, 2nd level, 3rd level. This is inheritance, correct? That means for whatever the methods are available in object, these are accessible inside the writer, because it is accessible in a writer, and then it is accessible in output file stream writer, and then it is accessible into the file writer. So it gets inherited, depends on the access specifier. It is directly accessible or indirectly accessible. We have to just cross check it. Okay, and for that we have to go here fields. Look what are the fields are available in the your, and go to the constructors. So no, there is no any constructor available for parameterless constructor available for the file writer. Only parameterized constructor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 parameterized constructors are available, and we can use this one, or we can use this one, string file name. So this will help you to construct a file writer object using a file object. So we'll try it. Yes, so here you have to create a file object. File class is available, and here you have to use the parameterized constructor of file class. So for this you have to import the statement, import java io.file, and now it is showing me error, because look the error. It is showing you unhandled exception type IO exception. That means you have to handle it. So before to do this, I will try to pass like this text file, abc.txt file. So I have not created yet. Directly at the time of execution, this object will create this file at the current location. You will see. For this, what we have to do, it is a check type of exception, and for this, you have to just go with the add throws declaration or surround with the try catch block. So two options are available. So if you don't want to handle this exception in a main method, so what you have to do, it you have to use a throws statement here, throws, and pass the exception to its caller. So who is the caller of main? It is a JVM. So you are passing like this. We can do throws. Which type of exception? IO exception. And for this you can import IO exception. So it is IO exception class. Now error is gone. So you can use a throws, or you can use another option. You have a surround with a try catch block. So it's like this. So in a try block you have a instruction, and catch block is for IO exception, and print structures is just to print the status of your error if any runtime error occurs. Okay, and now ABC gets created, and what you have to do is, suppose I want to take the data from user. So what we have to do, we have to define scanner, correct? So how to define a scanner? And here you have to go like this, correct? Scanner is available in your util package. So you have to import it. So import the java util, then here you have to define the string message is equal to sc dot next line, right? And whatever data is entered by the user, this will store into the message, and that message I want to write into the file. So I have a fw object, and you have to use a write method. Now you have, look how many write methods are, five write methods are available, but for my this application I have the third one, that is suitable, string str, and here I have to go with the message. Okay, and after that, if your program works successful, then you can go like this, flush. And you have to close the file object. Okay. So how many lines of code is available for the file writer? You just check it. First line. Then you have the second line for write the data, and these were closing instances. So hardly 4 to 5 lines of code is available in this scenario. So it is very easy to remember the code because the APIs are available in Java, and that is the benefit of Java, how to write the code. Okay, so my opinion to you is, if you want to write the closing instances, so you have to close these instances in a final block. Okay, and it is showing me error because now the file fw instance is available inside the try. So how to remove this? You just do one thing here, you have to declare it. Okay, and here go like this. Okay, now your error is gone, and now here also it is showing me error because fw instance may throw an exception. Here also you have to go like this, try catch, because your instruction is out of scope, and that's why you have to go like this. E dot print status. You can go with the exception, or you can go with the exception. Now look the code. Here I'm showing you code. File writer instance, initially it's a null. In a try block I created instance with the abc file, then I created a scanner to give a message to user and take an input from the user, and this, suppose user will enter a data, so it will scan and it will store into the message, and that message I'm going to write into the file using the file instance. And then if any exception occurs during the execution, then it will pass to the catch block. Catch block will handle it and it will print it, and after that we have to close the instances of file. This is the programmer responsibility, otherwise other cannot access the data and file may corrupt. So this is compulsory, we have to close the instance, and this is I am going to write in a finally, because finally block will execute at any situation, whether the exception occurs or whether exception doesn't occurs. Okay, now just I run the program. Hmm. Now look at when the message is available, enter the data which you want to write into the file, and then I will write here. Suppose this is the statement. Okay, I just make an enter. So only one line I am going to scan here using next line, and just now check whether the abc.txt gets created and data is available into that file or not. So users, we have Eclipse workspace, we have a file handling demo. Correct. And look at abc.txt gets created, and just I open this in Notepad++. Now look, the data is available. Welcome to TechEstude file handling demo. Correct. Is it okay? Now if you want to create another file, then I will try to create. Now just check it. So here I change the name XYZ. Save the program. Check within a location. XYZ is not available here, correct? And I execute the program again. Yes. And then I write here. Hello. How are you? Okay. Just enter. Then go back to your file location. Look, XYZ gets created, and just open this in Notepad. So XYZ.txt having hello, how are you? Okay. So how to write a data into the file? It's very easy using file writer, and this data is in human readable format. It is a character oriented approach. In a byte oriented approach, this is the data is not in human readable format. So data is in the byte app using a binary approach, right? So like images, video files and etc., or if you want to secure a data, you can go with a byte approach, and if you want to store a plain text, then go with a character oriented approach. So file writer class will help you to do this. Is it okay? So any doubt related to this? And here compulsory you have to provide a try catch block, otherwise compiler will give you error. It will not compile. So because file related exceptions are the checked exception, IO exceptions are checked exceptions, and the rule for checked exception is compulsory we have to provide a try catch block, or you have to write a throw statement. That means why we have to do like this, because Java will not take any guarantee about the check type of exception, because your Java programs depends on the external resources and which is not related to the Java. So in this case, file handling xyz.txt is the external resources. We cannot give any guarantee whether the file will create at a respective this location or not, because in this case, who will create a file? Obviously, Java will give the instruction to the operating system, and operating system will create these files. And in that case, if the location is properly not identified, definitely there is an abort operation, that is a corrupt or the illegal state of the process. In that case, definitely exception raised, and we have to follow that. We have to deal with that exception. That's why Java tells you to go with the proper exception. Okay. So any doubt in file writer? About the API, we have to understand this documentation. Okay, so here if you go to the methods, look, the methods are available. File write this one method summary, close flush encoding, and methods are inherited from writer and from the object. So this is write. Okay, you have the if you go with the writer, so this writer method which is available in your output stream, and this is used for character, this is used for string, and again two methods are from this one, writer class having a character array, and here you have a string. So we are using this one, correct? And this method, look at this write method, is of the class writer class. It is not a method of file writer, it is a method of a writer class, and file writer is your subclass of the writer. Look here. So first is, I think it's a output stream writer. So writer class having subclass output stream writer. So these write methods are inherited. These write methods are inherited into the file write output stream writer. Look at and output stream writer having the subclass file writer. So write method get inherited into output stream, and from the output stream it is get inherited into the file writer. And file writer class now use the write method, and this write method is not for file writer directly, but indirectly it is available. That is basically use of inheritance, right? So from the writer to output stream and output stream to the file writer, and we are working on this object of the file writer class. Clear? So we have to just refer it. Please refer the Java documentation and try to understand the Java documentation, how the methods are written into that, and how it's inherited, what are the different packages they use, from which package to which package the class is passed. Okay, so all these rules are given properly in only Java documentation. We have to refer it. So every programming language having their own documentation, standard documentation, like a C++ also having their own documentation, and your Java having their own documentation. Documentation is related to its respective versions of the technology. So it's a Java 8 documentation. Now recently Java 14 is going on, so Java 14 documentation is little bit different from that, but core classes and the hierarchy is the same. Okay, for Android you have Android documentation, for the Python you have a Python documentation, and without documentation no one can do the programming, because the rules we are using into the program is according to the documentation. Okay, and whatever books we are referring, it just to understand the theory of about the or fundamental knowledge about the technology. Okay, in the books the proper documentation is not available, because it is not easy to include it. It's a very lengthy. Okay, look at how many packages, and each package having how many classes. So approximately 50 to 100 classes and interfaces are available in each and every package, and how many packages, it's more than 70 something is there as per the latest versions. So approximately 8,000 to 9,000 classes and interfaces overall available in Java documentations, that is in Java API. Who can remember it? It is not easy to remember. Okay, so some of the basic packages we can remember it. So we are learning Java IO. Okay, now file reader. So how we have written the data into the file. Similarly, file reader will help you to read the data from the file. Now it's a reverse operation. A file reader class is used to read the data from the file, and it returns the data in the form of byte format, like a file input stream, because the wrapper is not available directly. We have to convert it. So it is easy to convert. For to read a data, we have to first create an instance of file reader. Now you have again two constructors. One is a string argument, another is a file instance. We can use any one, and to read a data we have a read method, and that read method returns you the integer, and this is in ASCII format, and it returns you -1 at the end of file, if any problem occurs. That means the end of how the file is reached at the end of file. File cursor is reached, file pointer is reached, and after that the your reading will stop. So read method gives you only integer. It is one by one it will read. So we have to convert into the character and put onto the console, and then after you have to close the instance of file reader. So look, file instance, file reader instance, first line syntax, that is the opening the file, then read the data and close the data. Okay, look, the code is available here. Here while loop is used. Why? Because we have to read one by one, and it returns with the integer. That's why it is stored in I, and after at the time of printing we convert it into the character. Okay, just try the code. So it's again a easy code. Okay, now create the file instance, file reader. Is equal to new file reader. Okay, and here you have to pass the instance of file. This one. Here you have to give a proper name of the file, abc.txt, and this is your relative path. abc.txt should be present inside your current folder. Okay, otherwise you can give a proper path is like this. This also works, but this is known as the absolute path. Okay. Okay, so it is known as absolute path. So I recommend you to always go with the relative paths. That is a proper one. Okay. This way. Just import the IO packages. Then this one import the file, and you have to handle the exception. So I will go with throws exception. Throws file not found exception. Here integer data, their character is equal to, so go with the data because char is equal, right? Just declare it while loop. And here you have to store a data. Data is equal to fr dot read, correct? And if this data will not reach to the minus one. So we have to, unless and until we just try to read that data. Okay. Now I will read a data and just print on the console. It is giving me exception that throws, so this is an exception. And then fr dot plus. Is it okay? Now I'm working on abc.txt. Just I close this console and I try to execute the code. Look at welcome to TechStude file handling demo. Now it is your data. I'll just try to modify the content in abc.txt. Here I try test 1, test 2, test 3, and just check the output. So this is data available in abc.txt. Try to read that data. I run the same program. Okay, save data is available here. Welcome text file and demo test 1, test 2, test 3. Is it okay? So using file reader, easily you can read a data and you can get the data and which is human readable part. Okay, and in this application what I did is I just created an instance of file reader. I passed the abc.txt, that is the input file, and here I'm reading the data using fr object, using the read method of fr object. It will read, it will store into the data, it will continue unless and until minus one is reached, minus one when it will reach, because at the end of file it will reach. Okay, so it will read and it will convert into the character because it is in integer format, and integer to character it will convert whatever the character is assigned to that integer values, it is displayed on the screen, that is in ASCII format, and then your instance gets closed. So look, the in a file writer, at the time of file writer example, I use a try catch block. Now here I am using throw IO exception. Suppose you don't want to use it, so you have another option. What you have to do, convert your surround, this is with the try and catch block. Okay, look, okay. Try catch block is available now, and put this code, okay, that's put this code into the try block. Okay, and fr.close here is equal to null. Okay, and here the file not found exception, here you have to go with the error exception. Okay, error is gone. And what is the proper one is use the finally block, because we have to read the, we have to close the instance properly and go with this. Showing me error because it is outside the try block. So finally block is not capable to handle the exception, that's why it is showing error. Here again you have to, what you have to do is right click, go with the option you have a surround with try catch block. It is okay. Now, same program with a different approach using exception handling. Just run the code, check program works fine. It's okay. And here also you can use another constructor, that is the first one. Don't use a file. Here you can remove it. Go with this. Run the program, same output. Okay, because the both constructors are available. One is using a file instance and another is using without file instance. So this was the previous one. And this was the latest one. Is it okay? So if you have a doubt, you can just make a comment. Thank you. So I stop here.